here from Blue Dog Prospecting, and if you're new to my channel, welcome. I'm just out at Dalmorton with Dennis from Gold Den. If you haven't checked out his channel already, go check it out. Got some good stuff, metal detecting and all that there. So he's just taking me up to this grave site, and we've got the mother. She's died on the 9th of December, 1899, an infant son, while giving birth apparently, and the infant son of the above died on the 9th of February, 1900, aged 2 months. So pretty sad. And that's a pretty good quality headstone for the day. But that's what it was like out here. As Dennis said, there's no doctors and nurses out here and hospitals, so that's what life was like on the goldfields back then in the 1900. So anyway, we're gonna head off into the scrub, get the gold rat sluices going if we can, do a bit of panning, try and get some shiny yellow for you guys. Catch up with you soon. So we're just coming into Dalmorton and Dennis filming there. So he's just showing me the old petrol bowser. Got a tree growing through it here. It's our petrol pump.
That's the old petrol pump from the service station that used to be up here many years ago. And it's got the mandarin tree growing through it there.
Alright, then this has got your gold rat sluice. We're down at the creek here. Secret location out Dalmorton. We're going to go for a bit of a dig. Flies are pretty bad here today, so we'll find a way into this creek and get back to you when we start digging some gold. Cheers. Oh, black snake there. How far did he go? Not a fan of snakes. I'm not a big fan of snakes. Yeah, true.
He started Australia's reptile park down there in Boston.
Yeah, right.
Dad used to catch snakes for him that before he had the park. He just had to have him in his backyard for it.
Yeah. Well, there you go. I do not like snakes. I'm walking up the bloody creek. Dennis can go that way, I'm walking up the creek. Bugger the snakes. Of course she's deep. I'm up to my bloody knees. Oh. Here I am trying to walk up the creek and avoid the snakes. There's a big python there. Big bugger. Just sunbathing on the bedrock in the creek here. So I'm walking up the creek trying to avoid them, and there's one there. Bugger me.
Down in the creek.
Okie dokie, we're here. We've just gotten here and starting to sprinkle with rain, unfortunately. Dennis is down there where he was having a go last time we were out here. Well, he was out here. He's just building a little dam with a tarp. I'm going to drop the sluice into this little bit of a waterfall we got here. And probably dig that section there out. There's a few heavies on that laying on top of this bedrock. A lot of, you see here, it's got a mixture of quartz, little veins running all the way through, all up here like tiger striping. And it's not thick quartz, It's very mild, but makes for a pretty looking rock. Anyway, have a scratch around here where these heavies are in the water. And if not, we'll have a go behind that rock and move around this area and try and learn this new little spot. So I'll set up this sluice. I'll get some dirt put into me pot there, and we'll start sluicing some dirt. See if we can get some shiny yellow for you guys. Call soon. So we've just gotten here. It's the Sunday, 2 days after Black Friday. I started smelling some real thick smoke. And Dennis is down there. And we can hear the fire crackling up in the bush here. So we've had two snakes and a bushfire so far moving in on us. So we've just gotten here. We haven't even set up the sluice yet. We've got about half a bucket of cons there. We're just tossing up what to do, whether we get the hell out of here or we keep going. So we'll just keep an eye on things here. We'll get back to you real soon. It's pretty worrying actually. See how we go. Hopefully all is safe. We're a bit worried about the car. It's way down the buggery around the creek there. So we don't have to make too much of a hasty exit. Anyway, we'll get back here when I know what's going on here. Might have to go for a walk. See if we can see these, where this fire is. I can definitely hear it crackling, so. Alright, get back to you very soon. So, Dennis is just over here. He's going for a wander up the hill because I've got no gum boots on. Typical barefoot bushman. So he's going to go for a wander up there and see if he can see the flames. See what's going on here. Make sure we don't get in any strife. Anyway, I'll keep an eye on him here, make sure he's alright. Wish us luck, everyone. Bit of an exciting episode today, a bit worrying actually, but hopefully all turns out good and we can get some yellow. I've already got one speck for about two handfuls of dirt. So we'll just have to see how we end up today. Might have to make a hasty exit. Just prospecting for you. Anyway, that's why we'd be safe out here in the bush. Alright, we've decided to get the hell out of here. And quick smart too. That's where Dennis was digging. The flames are coming up over the ridge there. Dennis has already made his way off. So, I better catch up to him. I'm getting the hell out of here. Because the fire's coming in pretty quick. So, I'll talk to you soon when I get back to the car, eh? Cheers. Alright. There's Dennis. I'm walking down the creek, staying away from the snakes. Bugger the snakes. Don't like them. So. Dennis has been brave, he's got gumboots on. I'm silly. Anyway, make our way out of here back to the car. Just to be on the safe side. You know, a bit of hint for you all, if there's any fires around you, best to just head home. Last thing you want is to get trapped in a firestorm or to have the car burn. So, it is raining a bit here. But the wind's picking up and it is blowing towards the vehicle, so Dennis is me right in today. Oh, he said we're gonna get out of here, we're getting out of here. Anyway, I'll watch where I'm walking here. It was about where I saw that big python and that black snake before. And I don't want to tread on those snakes, because I don't like them. Anyway, see you back at the car. We'll move on to a different spot and see how we go. See where they've been burned all up through here. We're on the other side of the mountain where the fire was, up over the other side of the hill there. And we'll go and make our way to a different spot. Got my chauffeur, Dennis there.
The bloody good one at that.
Get back to you soon when we find a new spot to go and have a dig. Well, got some trees here. Might have to pull them out the way. Right over them. Oop.
We're in a Toyota.
So we're just at Black Slate Creek. Ben's making his way down there. And probably have a dig here somewhere. Got a little water dragon on the log there. See how close I can get before it scampers. Okay. Little water dragon. Just sunbaking there on the log. We'll leave him be. And we'll head down here. Have a scratch around. So we're just having a look around the creek here. Try and work out where to have a scratch. So we've got just in front of the rock here, bit of a drop off area. And you see the water would come screaming down through here, hitting this rock, spreading like this, and in turn causing a bit of an eddy behind this rock here and this rock here. So you've got your heavy deposits there and there. So they're areas where you would normally have a bit of a scratch around. The water be dancing around these rocks here, swirling, lots of turbulence and things like that. And then you got a bit more of a drop and fall there, and another heavy deposit area over there, and there's a lot of bigger boulders and things. So just a few areas that you'd want to have a look if you're in a place like this. Make my way back up here a bit further and so what else we can show. You can see up there where Dennis is. The water be coming down, screaming through air, hitting this rock. Changing direction. Around there, around like an inside bend sort of thing. Be doing a lot of turbulence and swirling off that rock. Dropping out a lot of heavies here. Coming back around. You've got this rock here, it'll be coming up and over, and you got a lot of heavy deposit in there. So it's doing a lot of zigzagging and carrying on as it's making its way down. So it looks like a good little creek here. We might have a scratch. Whether or not there's gold in it, we don't know yet. Dennis hasn't done any testing here yet. So there's lots of fall to it as well. Good spots to set up the sluice. Yeah, we'll just go for a wander here and see how we go. Alrighty, so we've got a bucket of cons here. Just classified it down because with the little 6-inch backpack of sluice from Gold Rats here, and they do need to be classified down. I'm doing mine to about 1/4 inch. So we'll just run this bucket of dirt and see if we get any gold. No one's ever really done any digging here from what I can gather. I can't find any spots where anyone's been digging in this creek. So, and a bonus, haven't seen any snakes yet. That's one good thing. So Because I don't like snakes. I've said it a million times, and I'll say it again, I do not like snakes. I don't even care if it's a python, I just don't like them. So, give you a quick look at the beautiful little area we're working here. There's plenty of fall. Dennis is down yonder down there somewhere. I could see him a little while ago, I can't see him anymore, so he must have wandered off somewhere else. Anyway, keep feeding this sluice, see if we can show you some gold. We've got one speck from the last bloody creek, so there's a bull ant. Nasty little buggers. Anyway, he's on that side of the stream and I'm on this side of the stream. Should be right. So, keep feeding this here. See how active the mat is. Fair bit of water flow through there, but yeah. Keep going at it here. Get back to you soon when I'm finished. Do a clean up. Make sure there's some gold here. I'm just digging out of this hole right here. Pretty much pumping the cons back straight into it. Hopefully, fingers crossed, find some yellow. Alrighty, well, to be honest, I didn't expect to get any gold. So we've got a little bit, not a real lot. Just try and get this to focus here. There it is. About 5 or 6 specks there. See them there. Not a real lot, but better than nothing. So, got the sluice set back up again. And the big boil hole just there, sort of thing. So, might even give that a bit of a whirl and see if we can pull a bit more out of that. So, either that or we'll just keep cleaning this one out. Anyway, back to work. Thank you. Alright, time for my second clean up. See how deep that hole goes. Right up to me sleeve there. So it was only that deep, an ankle deep, and dug it right back in that bedrock, right out around up to about where I'm standing, and then back around. So I moved a fair whack of dirt. There's me mullock heap there, some of these bigger rocks that I pulled out. Anyway, I have seen some visible gold in the sluice this time, so hopefully get a bit more. Done a bucket and a half, which is about 30 litres, so. Anyway, we'll can this out and see how we go. Alright, so you can see now the water's cleaned up a bit. Make me way over the tailings pile here. How much of a bit of glare there. You can see how much I've cleaned out of that hole. It's pretty deep. So, but, the amount of gold we got out of that hole just doesn't warrant the amount of effort, unfortunately. So it is some nice chunky of gold, but as you can see from my finger there, it's just not enough of it. So I'll have one more bucket. I'll do one more bucket, I reckon, out of that hole there. So I imagine the water like I said earlier, would come bouncing around here and come down here, and would be rushing sort of around this rock, bouncing off this rock and creating a bit of an eddy here. And I reckon that's why this rock is so smooth and rounded out, from the amount of water that's swirling here when it's actually flowing, because from what I can gather from a bit of flood debris and stuff we've seen, the water does come up to about that level, which is about my head height. So I reckon there'll be rocks scraping away at here, so we'll get in there, I'll clean that out. I'll do one more bucket, because it's 20 past 3 in the afternoon now, and it's starting to get a bit late, so do one more and then I think it'll be pretty well home time. I haven't heard or seen Dennis for good part of an hour and a half, 2 hours now. He's down around the corner and down the buggery down there somewhere. Anyway, I'll suck that up with me schnapper bottle. Do one more, and then we'll get the hell out of here, because it's about 3 hours to Balmorton from my house, and I'm not going to get home until it's pretty bloody late, so I'll be in trouble by the missus tonight. We all know what that's like. Anyway, better get into it. Stop talking on the phone. Alright, so I was going to clean out this bit here. Instead, I moved the big rock there and this one here out of this bit of a channel here. There's a lot of overburden down there. I'm just using my bare hands to get the bloody rocks and that out. And something bloody latched onto me finger. And you got a cranky little yabby there. So that's why we call them yabby pumps. For those of you who don't know, and that is a yabby. Freshwater yabby. That's pretty cool. He's cranky too. He's not happy that I got him. Anyway, I'll leave him up there for a minute so he doesn't snap me finger again. And, as if he doesn't crawl out of me pan. So hopefully his mate's not in there, because that bloody hurt. Anyway, back into it. Good stuff. That's a nice big yabby too. I'll let him go after. They can survive out of water for a little while, but I'll fill that pan up and they'll keep him happy in there. So put some water in there for the yabby. Sorry about the glare. See him in there. So he's happy. We'll put that over there so he doesn't get out and bite me again. Get this dirt out the way and see if there's any gold. Another thing we've got to look out for here in Australia. I know you can see him underwater there, just there. There's a spider down there. So there he is. That's a huntsman. You can see the air bubbles around him there. And what them air bubbles say, get that around their exterior so they can still breathe underwater. Quite often here when we're prospecting, you'll be moving rocks and you'll have spiders come out of the water at you. So a bit of wildlife today. A little bit of gold, not much, but it's just an adventure. So back into it. Alright, this is it, folks. It's getting late. I'd say Dennis is waiting for me up at the car already. You can see a bit of gold in there. I'll show you how quick this stuff exchanges out. And this catches the most finest of micro gold too. So, you know, if you're catching real fine stuff, you ain't losing a lot. Anyway, I'll finish this bucket off. Not much to go now. Pan it off, show you what we got, show you where we got it from, and we'll pack up and we'll go home. Okie dokie. That bucket's done. Sluice is just there. First hole I dug just next to the sluice there. Took a little bit out of here. No gold. And this is where we were digging just then. Come around this side. That's pretty deep. It's well past my knee there, or up to my knee there. So, taking a fair whack out of there. And that's still sloping down like that. So I reckon if I took all of this out, because if bedrock comes back up here, this would be like a big boil hole. Maybe next time though, not today. We got Yabby there. I'll call him Gabby the Yabby. And I think we'll let him go, eh? And put him back into his little hole where he came from. Off he goes. There you go, mate. Back in his home there. And that's a New South Wales red claw yabby. We've got red claws and blue claw yabbies here. So, nice little bit of wildlife for you guys today. We've had two snakes and lizards and frogs and yabbies and spiders and... Anyway, I'll do this final clean up here. Show you what gold we got. Head back down the river and find Dennis. Or creek, sorry. And, excuse my cameras there, just putting things down, and then we'll get the hell out of here. So before I do go, I'll just explain to you why I chose this spot. Even though the creek's running down, and as I said, bouncing around off these rocks, I chose this spot because there's this big boulder in the way. Yes, I busted my back moving it. And another big boulder there, and all that sort of overburden, and that's me mullet keep. So anyway, the reason I chose this spot was because I noticed the bedrock was sloping down. There was these big rocks which caused their own low pressure system. I tested here, there was nothing there. You know, most people go for, you know, your horizontal sort of bedrock running this way, like I was behind that one. Now, quite often you'll get all this smooth bedrock, and I notice there's a lot of gravel build up here. So what that tells me is that all this bouncing around is causing a lot of velocity. So obviously when it's hitting this big rock, and you can see how deep it was in the ground, there's only that top bit sticking out, that all that section was underwater. In the mud, sorry, and I've just flipped him up like that. Anyway, I got some of my best gold today out of that one. So you don't always have to look at stuff that's running horizontal to the river or the creek. So I'll just show you what we got here today, or in that last one, sorry. Bit hard because we've got all of this bloody ironstone and that here. Just pull some of that out of the way. And you see the gold we got out of that. Anyway, so that was one bucket. My last bucket, like I said. And you see some nice chunky bits of gold in there. Well, that's a flat piece, that's a nice chunky piece. So that's much better. And it just goes to show you, you know, most people would have just overlooked that because it's running straight down with the river or with the creek, and the flow's coming straight around here and channeling through there. But anyway, that's a little bit we got there. I'm gonna pack all of this gear up, put it in my backpack. Car's just down around the bend there. Go and find Dennis, and we'll show you all the gold we got for the whole day. Pretty much got more in that last bucket than I did all day, but that's the way it is, eh? I don't gamble, I don't drink, I prospect. So I pretty much gamble prospecting. Anyway, guys and girls, we'll get back to you when we get back to the car. Show you what we got for the day. Get the hell out of here. So we're back at the car, getting ready to go home. Dennis been sitting here waiting for me.
No worries. It's relaxing out in the bush, I love it.
I'll take this lid off and show you what Dennis is going to do it for me.
Show you the stuff I got.
Not a real lot today, but that's all right.
Better than what I got. I got one spec.
So I got some decent looking,
couple of nice pieces,
size there. Bits there. Got to see a bit of nature. Got to catch Gabby the Yabby. And kept him pet for a few hours. I was just telling Dennis about him. Anyway.
Is he a big one?
He was a big one. He's about this big. He just fit in my pan.
Should have brought it home for a snack.
Nah, Red Claw. I think they're protected, eh?
I don't know.
Anyway, I'll suck that back up with my schnuffer bottle. Jump in the car.
You're driving.
And Dennis is going to suck him up. Anyway, as I normally say, when the sun's getting low, the shadows are getting long, or what is it? When the shadows are getting long and the sun's getting low, it means that it's time to go. Anyway, I'm Blake from Blue Dog Prospecting. And it's Dennis from Gold Den. Go check out his channel. And we're getting the hell out of here. Thanks for watching.